बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामु अलैकुम। इट इज़ लेक्चर नंबर 4 ऑफ बेसिक स्टैटिस्टिक्स कोर्स। बिफोर स्टार्टिंग टुडेज लेक्चर, आई रिक्वेस्ट एवरीवन, इफ़ यू आर स्टिल डिप्राइव्ड ऑफ बीइंग अ मेंबर ऑफ माय चैनल, सब्सक्राइब टू माय चैनल, लाइक एंड शेयर माय चैनल एंड क्लिक द बेल आइकन फॉर द नोटिफिकेशन ऑफ द नेक्स्ट वीडियोज। लेट्स स्टार्ट। क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 इज फाइंड अरिथमेटिक मीन, ज्योमेट्रिक मीन एंड हारमोनिक मीन ऑफ द सीरीज। द सीरीज इज 1, 2, 4, 8, 16 अप टू सो द लास्ट वैल्यू इज 2^n। दैट इज़ अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन फॉर ऑल द पेपर्स ऑफ स्टैटिस्टिक्स। यू नो द फॉर्मूला ऑफ अरिथमेटिक मीन, दैट इज समेशन एक्स ओवर एन। द सम ऑफ ऑल द वैल्यूज 1+2+4+8+16+2^n over the number of values. How many values are there? Actually, 1 can be written as 2^0 and 2 can be written as 2^1. 4 can be written as 2^2 up to so on. It means there are n+1 values in this series. And now that is a rule of mathematics. If you want to add up the values, actually you want to find out the sum of all the values, the formula is a1 into r^n-1 over r-1. If r, which is ratio, that is greater than 1, if you divide second value by 1, r will be equal to 2/1, that is 2. If you divide 4/2, that will be 2. If you divide 8/4, 4 2s are 8, that will be 2. Ratio is same and that is greater than 1, then that formula will be used. If you want to find out the sum of values when the ratio is same, that formula will be used, a1, which is the first value, into r^n, and number of values, r is the ratio, minus 1 whole divided by r-1. That is the numerator of finding the arithmetic mean. a1 is the first value, which is 1, into r is the ratio, and that is 2^n. Number of values are n+1-1 divided by r-1. R is 2, 2-1 is 1, and that is the denominator of arithmetic mean, n+1. And in the exam, the last answer of that question will be 2^n+1-1 over n+1. You will tick that option in the paper. Now geometric mean you will have to find. We know if there are two numbers a and b, the geometric mean will be a multiplied by b under the root. Multiply all the numbers and take power 1 by number of values, and in that question you will have to multiply 1, multiply by 2, multiply by 4, multiply by 8, multiply by 16, up to so on. Last value is 2^n and whole power is 1/n+1. Now, 1 can be written as 2^0, 2^1, 4 can be written as 2^2, 2^3, 2^4, up to so on, 2^n. And the whole power is 1/n+1. And this is the rule of basic mathematics. When bases are same, 2 is the base, and there is a sign of multiplication, powers will be added. 0+1+2+3+4, up to so on, plus n, and the whole power is 1/n+1. And we know if you want to add all the consecutive numbers, the formula is n(n+1)/2, and the whole power is 1/n+1. That will be cancelled with this much, and the last answer in the paper is 2^n/2. That is a very important MCQ for all the papers of statistics. Find out the geometric mean for the series 1, 2, 4, 8, 16 up to so on, 2^n. 100 of questions can be constructed by this. The last answer will be 2^n/2. Now the last target is harmonic mean. Harmonic mean, the formula of harmonic mean is n over summation 1 over x. Just substitute the values. In that series, there are n plus 1 values actually. And in the denominator, you will have to take the reciprocal of all the values. 1 over 1 plus 1 over 2 plus 1 over 4 plus 1 over 8 plus 1 over 16 plus up to so on plus 1 over 2 raised to the power n. Now I discussed a formula with you. When you want to add up all the values where the ratio is same, actually r is second value divided by first value, 1 over 2 over 1, that is 1 over 2. If you divide 1 over 4 by 1 over 2, that will be 1 over 2, ratio is same. The sum will be a1, 1 minus r raised to power n over 1 minus r. That is the denominator, and the numerator is n plus 1 over. What is the first value, which is 1? 1 minus r is 1 over 2, and the power is n plus 1 whole divided by 1 minus 1 over 2, which is 1 over 2. Now that will be multiplied over here. The last answer will be n plus 1 over 2, 1 minus 1 over 2 raised to power n plus 1. That will be the last answer in the paper. Find the harmonic mean. Question number 2, the percentage of values in a frequency distribution lying between upper and lower quartile. Very important one, question number 2. We know if Q1 is over here, for example, Q1 is 79 marks. It means that 20%, 25% students have marks less than 79. 25% people have marks less than 79. If Q3 is over here, if it is 89.5, it means 75% students have marks less than 89.5. And the question is, how many students are lying between 83, Q3 and Q1? What is the percentage of the values of the marks, you can say, in the frequency distribution lying between Q3 and Q1? That will be 50%. 75% minus 25%, that will be 50%. Now question number 3. The percentage of values which is to the right of 87th percentile. If you have 87th percentile over here, 87% values are less than, then 13% values will be on the right of P87. Question number 4 is, the percentage of values which are to the left of 6th decile. Question number 4 is, if D6 is over here, it means 60% values are to the left of D6 and 40% values are to the right of D6. Question number 5. Harmonic mean gives more weightage to the small values. What is the formula of harmonic mean? That is n over summation 1 over x. If the values of x are 2, 4, 10 and 20, you find out 1 over x, 1 over 2 which is 0.5, 1 over 4 which is 0.25, 1 over 10 which is 0.1 and 1 over 20 which is 0.05. In x, that is the largest value, but harmonic mean gives 0.05, which is the least value. That is the meaning of harmonic mean gives more weightage to the small values, which is 0.5, and less weightage to the large values. That is the drawback of harmonic mean. Question number 6, harmonic mean gives less weightage to the large values. 20 is the largest value in the data, and harmonic mean is giving the द लेस वेटेज दैट इज 0.05. क्वेश्चन नंबर 7. Given the following less than tie frequency distribution of the pocket money in rupees. Less than 3500, 3250, 3000. 2750, 2500, 2250, and number of children are also given. 185, 65, 60, 27, and 12. Dear students, keep in mind whenever in the paper, in the exam, less than type data or more than type data are given, it means that column is not of the frequency, that is the column of cumulative frequency. Actually, that is C dot F is given. First of all, you can write that data in the ascending order, and you can note the difference is 250 rupees only. In every class, you can check that there is a difference of 250 rupees. And if I start from the ascending order, less than 2250 means 2000 to 2250. Then 2502, 2500, 2500 to 2750, 2750 to 3000, 3000 to 3250, and 3250 to 3500. And what is the value of for this much? That is 12. Now, if you want to find out the frequency for this class, that will be 27 minus 12. And that is 15. Then 60 minus 27, that will be 33. 65 minus 60, it is 5. 85 minus 65, that is 20. And 100 minus 85, that is 15. That is the frequency. In the exam, if less than or more than type data is given, that column is for the cumulative frequency. And if I write in the ascending order, that was the difference of 250 rupees, I make the classes and I find out the frequency. The first frequency was 12, and actually that is the cumulative is given. If you find out the frequency, subtract 27 minus 12, that will be 15. Then 60 minus 27, 33. In this way you can find out the frequencies. Now you can solve all the questions. Write the frequency, cumulative frequency again. 12, 27, that is 60, 65, 85, and 100. Now the question is, the median class of pocket money is, if you want out the median class, the formula is n over 2. N is actually summation f, or the last value of the cumulative frequency, which is 100. 100 over 2 is 50. Now check in the cumulative frequency, that class, that will be the correct option in the exam. The pocket money between 2500 and 2750. Question number 8. Find the upper quartile class. A very important one. Upper quartile Q3. 3n over 4. How will you find out? That will be 75. N is 100. 100 multiplied by 3. 300 over 4. That will be 75. And now you will have to find out in cumulative frequency. That class will be 3000 to 3250, that class will be selected. Question number 9 is, find the lower quartile class. Lower quartile means Q1, and that will be n over 4. N is 100 over 4, that will be 25. Now you will have to find out the value of 25 in cumulative frequency, and that will be the class 2250 to 2500 rupees. That will be the last and correct answer in the exam for Q1. Question number 10 is, what is the 7th decile class? 7th decile means D7, and you will have to take 7n over 10. 7 multiplied by 100 over 10, that will be 70. Now find out cumulative frequency, 70. The same class will be selected. That will be the correct option.
The last question of today's lecture is, what is the 45th percentile class? 45th percentile P45. For this, you will have to take 45 n over 100. That will be 45 into 100 over 100, 45. Find out in commutative frequency, that will be 60. 45 is lying in this much. 2500 to 2750 will be the correct option in the exam. Assalamu alaikum.